So our theoretical discussion we had stopped at the concept of deemed ownership. Ownership has 3 points. If you remember, ownership include beneficial ownership and deemed ownership. The second point was subletting, and the third point is deemed ownership. All right, I'll just show you the chart. But before I show you the chart, let us understand and read the legal context. Okay, sir. Deemed ownership means they are somebody else on paper, Benami. So owner will be somebody else and real control will be somebody else. Okay, we took that example of spouse. Okay, so here the first subsection that they are talking about is first clause of section 27 that they are discussing with us is the transfer of property to spouse. Transfer of property to spouse. I gave you one example where owner gifted the house property to wife. Okay, obviously for consideration or without consideration. I can call it gift only if it is without. Wife doesn't have 1 crore rupees to buy property from husband. It's just given. Alright. And what was the intention behind transferring the property? Tax evasion. So they have already captured the situation under deemed ownership. Now you cannot do that thing. People are doing it, sir, because they don't know section 27. Hello? If you know section 27, then you will not evade taxes in that way. Okay, so what they are writing here, in case of transfer of house property, in case of transfer of house property by individual to his or her spouse, his or her spouse, wife to husband or husband to wife, alright, otherwise than adequate consideration, bina paise liye, without sufficient money, you understand, alright, the transferer, hello, transferee is the legal owner, transferer is the deemed to be owner of the property. You understand? So I have transferred property. She is the legal owner. But sir, you are the deemed owner. I am the deemed owner. You understand? Transferer is the deemed owner. Hello? You understood this? Wait. So there is a chart. The chart is again invisible. So transfer of property to wife. The wife word has to be cut and the right word is spouse. Okay, example I am giving of wife. So this is our assessee. This is male assessee. Alright. He is known as the transferer. Okay. He is real owner. He is real owner. I will write deemed also. He is real owner. Yes or no? Alright. What real owner have done? Real owner have given property. Real owner have given house property. To whom? Come on, tell me. Spouse. And spouse transfer is the assessee. And spouse is transferee. And spouse is legal owner. Hello, you tell me. And this transfer of property. This transfer of property has done, okay, assessee will write here, this transfer of property was done otherwise than adequate consideration. Look at the language. Otherwise than adequate. Otherwise than adequate consideration means it was done without consideration. It was done without consideration, or it was done either without means there is no consideration, or sometime wife has given me consideration, 1 rupiya, 5 rupees. Do you get property in 5 rupees, 500 rupees, 1000, 1 lakh? No. So that consideration is there, but it is not adequate. So that is inadequate consideration. So either transfer was without consideration or inadequate. This is the case. You understood the case? Alright. How government will capture this? Who will earn rent? Come on. Who will earn rent? Spouse will earn rent. Legal owner will earn rent. What government will do? Government will take this particular rent and government will say to this legal owner, do not tax, not taxable. Hello, you spouse, you please don't pay tax. Who will pay tax? Who is the deemed owner? Hello? Transferer. Sir, you pay tax. Sir, you pay tax. Then this guy will shout, I am not owner. You are deemed owner. Transferer is the deemed owner. Assessee is a deemed owner. Transferer is a? He is a deemed owner. He is a deemed owner. Am I clear? Now, please see this. exception, if you can read it. Exception, in case of transfer to spouse in connection with an agreement to live apart, agreement to before divorce. See, after, if you sign divorce paper, divorce, first of all, you cannot sign. Divorce has to be declared by court. Now in India, court takes their own time. Alright, so before divorce declared by court, you people sign agreement to live apart, mutually. You people sign agreement to live apart, and sometime husband has to transfer his house property to spouse for agreement to live apart. You understood this case? Hello? Okay. Husband is saying, you take my house property. Don't take only house property. Take car. Take refrigerator. Take music system. Take whatever hell you want. But ja. Nikal. Alright. Now you tell me, this transfers are done genuinely or with a tax evasion? What is the intention? This is genuine, regular, or with a tax evasion intention? No, genuine, alright. And therefore they say, agreement to live apart is an exception to the law. Agreement to live apart is an exception to the law. So sir, is there any exception to deemed donor? Yes, there is the exception, and that exception is agreement to live apart. Am I clear with this much? Hello? Alright. Now in second chart, okay. So now you cannot do, can you do manipulation by using your spouse? Your wife and your husband, can you do that particular manipulation now? No, because there is a provision of deemed owner. You are writing this? Not done? Can you write done first? Chalega, samjha? Alright, now please understand. Now you cannot do this with your spouse. You understood this. Now you cannot do it with spouse. Then, with whom you will do it? Child. You will do with your child. Now there are two types of child you might have, or SSC might have. Alright, minor child and major child. Minor means minor. Below 18. It can be 2 months baby, 10 months baby. And it can be like you, ghoda, 22 varshacha, 22 years animal. Come on, tell me. With whom tax planning is easy?
Minor child.
Minor. Why your father will not transfer property on your name? Give me one logic. For tax evasion, will your father transfer all property on your name?
No.
No, because your father has seen Bagban movie at least multiple times. If not Bagban, then if you are Maharashtrian, then at least that Nana Patekar movie. Nata Samrat. Some people, like, out of happiness, they transfer property and then they have to go to some Rudrasham, you know. So, your father is smart guy. And if he's not, if he's trying to be dumb, tell him, Papa, no. You are making a very, very big mistake. Don't transfer property on my name for evading tax. You may evade tax, but lose your property, bro. I will adjust this property, don't worry. Don't worry at all. So, the second manipulation that can happen, possible to happen, is with minor child, okay? Sir, why did you produce two? Because one is girl and one is boy. You understand? You can use your, why they are smaller than SSC? Because they are minor. Okay? So now transfer is minor child. Okay? Minor child. Girl or boy. Both possibilities are there. Sir, this is 6 month old baby. Please understand, this is a 6 month old baby who owns property in Mumbai. Okay? Who purchased property in Mumbai, in fact. Okay? Who found a tenant. Okay? Who negotiated with tenant, sign an agreement with tenant, collecting every month rent, maintaining the property, paying taxes. Hello? Everything this 6 month old baby is doing, only thing that he doesn't know is how to shit and how to do piss. Piss and shit is still doing in his own pant. Apart from that, he knows everything else. Is it possible? Hello? Come on, tell me. Susu pant me karta hai. And he has managed to purchase property. Is it possible? No. So who has purchased property? Can you tell me? Legal owner is the legal owner of a property. Who has purchased property for him? His parents. You understand? So don't be so happy and don't love your father if your father has created FD on your name, created debenture on your name, created house property on your name. Don't be so happy and exciting about it. Your father doesn't love you, beta. Your father loves money. And he has tried saving taxes by keeping you happy. Obviously, you are also happy. Oh, I have FD of 10 lakh rupees on my name, you know. That FD was created on your name with only one intention. To evade tax. That property was purchased on your name with only one intention. To evade tax. You are getting my point?
Yes.
So this happened. Sir, is there any exception? Yes, there is also exception. That exception, every whole chart is same. Alright. That exception here is minor married daughter. I call it MMD. Minor married daughter. So minor married daughter is an exception. Minor married daughter is an... Why, sir? Because in India, there was a culture of getting married at age of 12 to 14. Yeah. Earlier. And boy is also young, girl is also young, and they are starting their new life. Obviously, at the age of 12 to 14, I don't think so that you are having enough maturity to handle your own life. So both parents, not only girl's parents, both parents, you understand, will contribute something to their new life. Hello? Will contribute something to their new life. They may give jewelry, they may give cash, they may give some asset. One of the common asset that usually girl's father used to give in earlier days, alright, was a house property. Now you tell me, daughter, 12 year daughter is getting married, father is giving property to her on the marriage date. You tell me, is it for tax evasion?
No.
No, obviously the intention was not tax, it was the custom. Now it has become dowry, unfortunately. Thank God in Mumbai we don't have this system. Hello?
Yes.
We are living in such a good place that at least parents are well matured now that they don't demand. Alright. Still there are some shameless people who demand. And if your parents are one of them, then sorry. Alright. You are in a wrong company. They are making you beggar. They are trying to sell you. Alright. So this is wrong. Something is wrong. It has to change. Someone like us has to change the system. So dowry is not good. Dowry is bad. Now that time it was good because that time the marriage was happening at 12 to 14. Now marriage is happening at the age wherever you want to happen it. Hello? Some of you wanted to happen it, but it is not happening. That is another case. So your parent, like, they are stopping it. Like, don't. Abhi akkal nahi hai tujhko. Alright. But now marriages are happening and husband and wife both are becoming equally independent, equally matured, equally literate. At least in cities, major cities of India. So this thing is not happening and nobody is now having property to gift. Lele, beti, do ghar lekar ja tum. That time father used to have this kind of wealth. Now father is also struggling. Alright. Father's wife, who is your mother, she is also struggling. And they are struggling. Would you like to have a property from them? No. So now this culture has gone. But still there is an exception. If minor married daughter. Sir, what if daughter is major? First of all, if daughter is major, your father will not transfer the property. Because tax evasion is not possible. Tax evasion is possible, but daughter is matured now. If check get deposited in her account, father have no expectation. I evaded tax successfully, but that money is gone. Alright. So, if the son or child becomes major, then clubbing provision obviously not attract. It will attract only if child is minor. Okay? So, this is the second logic, second chart that you have. Transfer of property to minor child. Okay? So, there is a chart again. Alright? And then there are points below this. Okay, so I will directly take those points. Now in a major section is done, only first two sections was having lot of discussion. Okay, now I'm teaching you from your module. So section 27 clause 1, it was for transfer of property to spouse or to minor child. Hello, but exception is agreement to, come on, tell me, for spouse what is the exception? Agreement to leave apart. And for minor child, what was the exception? Minor married daughter. Am I clear? They have given one example also, you can read that example later on. Now second deemed owner in your points you are having is holder of impartible estate. The word is impartible estate. Impartible estate means, if Dadaji has died, today everybody will cry and tomorrow everybody will fight for what?
Property.
You understand? Now if there is no fight, if Dadaji have written death will properly or brothers are matured enough, hello, then they will divide property. Two brothers, then they will divide equally 50-50. Hello. Or one will take land, one will take house, one will take properties, one will take cash. So division may happen fair. But sometimes division is not fair. It's unfair. Hello. Alright. Then there will be dispute. There will be one property in Mumbai. And everybody want that property. You understand? And then there is no solution. So the matter will reach to, if division happens, then there is no problem. But sometimes division doesn't happen. Alright, batwara nahi hota. Possible. Alright, so matter will reach to court. And once matter reach to the court, please understand, once matter reach to the court, you know Indian judicial system. Court will take their own time to settle the case. Maybe 10 years, maybe 5 years, maybe 8 years, God knows. And during that time, that property is let out property. And somebody has to pay tax of that property. Now that somebody has already died. Legal owner of the property has already died. And new owner has not registered because matter is pending in the court. Yeah. Alright, so what is the solution? Solution is this, court will call those all claimant. Like whoever wanted to claim that property, they will call and they will see their profile. One of them will be literate one. Maybe better one than others. Alright, who understand law, legal provisions and all. So court will appoint them, that particular person as a holder of impartible estate. Impartible means disputable. Am I clear? Hello? He did not become owner today. Court has just appointed him for taxation matter. Okay? So that guy will file two income tax return. One for his own income and one for Dadaji. Hello? Okay? Yeah? That guy, then he will say, I am not owner, you are a deemed owner. You are not legal owner, but you are a deemed owner. Okay. In Mumbai, I don't find it difficult to explain what is member of cooperative society. Okay. We all majorly live in a cooperative society. So this satellite park is also a cooperative society. Alright. If your flat number is on 7th floor, alright, 702 is your flat, do you own whole building and land upperton and there too? No, you are just owning that particular corner of the building. Alright, so who own this building and land?
Society.
Come on, tell me, who own this land? Cooperative society. So legal owner of building and land is? You are the member of society, therefore you are staying in 702. But who is the legal owner of the society, that particular building? Society. You understand, cooperative society. Who will pay tax? Who is taking rent from this tenant? Society or you? Hello, you own this particular property, you have kept one tenant, who is collecting rent? Who is keeping tenant? Member, no? The guy, the owner name is member. Member is appointing tenant, member is taking rent, who will pay tax? But member is not a legal owner. You understood the problem, member is not? Then who is the legal owner? Society. So who will pay tax? Come on, tell me. Society or member? Who should pay? Who is the real owner? Huh? Who controls? Who controls this particular flat? Who owns this flat? Member, no. So who is the real owner? So who will pay tax? Society just legal owner. Who is the real owner? So member will pay tax, no. So member is a deemed owner in next particular thing. So member of cooperative society is there. Alright, next. Now very important discussion we are going to have, not from the law perspective, house property perspective, but from a general perspective I am telling you. Alright, majority of your parents who are semi-literate or illiterate or over-literate. So there are these types of people. Okay, semi-literate, no literate and over-literate. They have this kind of understanding that they understand everything. Alright, and what will happen? They will go and they will sign, they will buy a property from some guy. Okay, this type of cover will be there and these papers will be green papers. Yes or no? Ownership means what for your property, for your parent? Please teach them this today. Have you seen property papers in your life? It will be a bunch of papers like this. No, agreement will be very huge. Purchase agreement or sale agreement. Lot of clauses are there. Alright. And beyond, first page will be that stamp duty value paper, stamp paper. Bharat Sarkar. Okay. So that symbol will be there. So you paid like you took that agreement and all. Now she is a seller. I am the buyer. She will sign every page. I will also sign every page. There are a lot of clauses written, consideration clause, this clause and that clause. And toward the end, two witnesses will also sign. Alright. And now I will give her 1 crore rupee check. She will give me this agreement along with keys. Yes or no? Today I am happy that I became owner of the property. And she is okay that she sold the property, she got the money. Am I clear? You people feel, these people feel transaction ends here. Now please tell me, if she can sign this agreement on green pages with me, she can sign with some X guy, Y, Z and 10 more, because green papers are available in stationery shop. Hello? Nahi, original hai na sir, originally milta hai. Hello? You don't become owner by taking this agreement with you. Yes, this is the evidence that you paid the consideration. But you don't become owner with this particular paper. You have to take her agreement and to witness to property registrar office. On registrar office there will be computer with that Aadhaar card, Aadhaar camera, you know that they will be having camera. Alright, she will go and sit on that seat, smile, I will switch, alright, I will put my thumb, she will put her thumb, because sign can be forged, thumb cannot. I cannot cut her thumb and take it there. And even if I take, registrar will not allow. Are person kidhar hai? Only thumb is not allowed. Whole person has to be there. You understand? Alright. So this thing has to happen. Now that date is the date of registration. That date is date of? And this date is date of agreement. You become actual legal owner from which date? Date of registration. When your name is entered into property registrar document, in Maharashtra we call it 7-12, 7-12 SPRAC. So your name has to go on that particular form. In registrar record you should be owner. Now she cannot sell this property to somebody else, because if she goes again to registrar office will slap herself, say that you are already sold this particular property, you are not having title. A person who doesn't have title cannot transfer title. To transfer title, you must have title. And when will I have title? I am a buyer. When will I have title? If this property is registered on my name in office of registrar. Am I clear?
Yes.
Hello? But emotionally, I become owner from each date.
Agreement.
I took key. I started also staying in this property. Emotionally, I am owner from today. Emotionally, she sold property. Emotionally, I purchased property. Okay, this transaction happened now. Registration is going to happen next year. Okay, this year assessment has to happen now. Okay, you tell me, will she show this property in her assessment?
No.
You understand my question? Before 31st March, we have signed agreement. But we did not get property register. Registration will happen in the month of April, May, because registration charges were not there with me. 5% stamp duty I have to pay. So another 5-6 lakh I have to arrange. So I told her we will do registration in like April, May, June. She is okay. She doesn't mind it. It's very risky, but she doesn't mind it. Hello. All right. So you tell me. In current year, who will show property to income tax department that I own this property or she own this property? Who is the legal owner of the property? She is the legal. Who is the real owner of the property? Who is staying in the property? You understand? So this section says, person with a possession of a property is the owner. Person with a
possession.
So who is having possession? Who is having keys? I have keys. I don't have legal ownership, but I have keys with me, and that transaction is written in section 53A of TOPA. TOPA means Transfer of Properties Act. Alright. So 53A of so you are not, so department will tell me, Ram sir, you are not legal owner, but you are a deemed owner. Hello? Because you have possession of the property and you have given a consideration. Your performance is done. Now only registration is pending. Okay? In Mumbai, we have culture of not signing agreement more than 11 months. Yes or no? We don't sign rent agreement more than? Because some section in income tax, section 269 UA in income tax, this section talks like this, that if you have 12 month right in the property for 12 continuous years, you get tenancy right in the property, you become deemed owner of the property. Not legal owner, but you become
owner.
And therefore in Mumbai, they don't sign agreement of 12 month. They sign agreement of, even if you are staying in the same property, after every 11 month, they will renew. Hello?
Yeah.
You understand? The contract is subject to renewal. Hello? Because if you have agreement for 12 continuous years, then according to income tax, one of the section, you become deemed owner. Okay? That is not that important, so let's not go into this. So it is there. One example they have given. Major thing, major discussion is done from my side. Okay, now there is one chart. That chart I need to make it properly because it's not properly visible in this book, and I have to teach online. So I need to make that chart. Okay, so we can take a break.